reviewing the stuff that passed.
All right. I'm handing that over to you. So that is just some conflicting some dates that the counselors said that you would need time off, so.
Okay. I can start off with a reopen, right, so we're.
Yeah.
Okay, but I can start off with a camp account and break that down for you guys. So we do have 6 days, not including, so we had a couple of.
Okay.
Registrations, so.
Yeah, they're in my car.
That's fine, so as a, without what she has, we have 60 campers.
It was 62.
62.
It was, but my count was off. I was wrong, I went through the whole thing, it was me, I doubled up on.
But we do, but we do have 62, actually. Yes, I have two in my car.
Okay, so we're at, we are at 62, but I'll give you the count for 60. So it's 60, if I break it down by grades, so grades 1 to 3, we have 26 campers. Grades 4 to 5, we have 17 campers. Grades 6 to 8, we have 17 campers.
And I know one of our new registration was a sixth grader going into seventh, so that would be 18, and one is a fifth grader.
You know, I gotta say, I'm really pleasantly surprised at that age group, the amount of kids we've got for that group. The older group, yeah.
Can you quickly just go back to the first fifth grader then?
Yeah, it's 26 campers. And pre-care. It's total of 17. I'll break that down. Grades 1 to 3 is 9 campers. Grades 4 to 5 is 2 campers. Grades 6 to 8 is 6 campers. Next, one is post-care, total of 9 post-care. Grades 1 to 3 is 4 campers. Grades 4 to 5 is 2 campers. Grades 6 to 8 is 3 campers.
Three.
Yes, ma'am. Do you know if on the registrations you have, are asking for pre and post?
I believe they are not.
Okay, that's good.
So as far as health or so.
I did tell you verbal about 1 post, right?
You did.
Okay, did that, is that very clear?
I think I already had that, actually.
Really, because I just had the money already. So I have a copy of that.
Let me just check the name.
You have to say it to me. Yes.
This section under Janessa, is that, are those the weeks that she can be doing that in which 2 days?
Yes, those are the full two, yeah, she can be there every day those 2 weeks.
So Janessa's just part of that, but basically she can.
Did you say she was post? Post or pre?
Post.
I already have.
Okay.
That's, she's already.
So council lines, when you had thought capping at 16, eight to 1, that's you. Is it, are we comfortable calling 17?
Some votes, right? My opinion would be yes.
I didn't understand your question.
With two counselors, we were capping pre and post at 16 campers.
Eight to 1 ratio.
Eight.
Right.
We're over by 1 for pre K.
She's talking about two counselors per pre and post.
Oh, I'm sorry.
So is that, how do you feel about that?
I think it's, in my opinion, I think it's okay to go with the 17, maybe we should cap it at 17 now, but I think it's acceptable to go.
I think that's fine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because they're 6 to 8, so they're pretty.
Yeah, they're not even gonna be with it.
True.
And they're still be 7.
She's not one of them.
Oh.
And even, you know, the 9 that we had, I don't know, well, I think, do we want 2 people here anyway, that way for pre and post regardless of numbers?
Correct.
Yes, so.
That's probably still going to staff, like, the 7 situation.
Yeah, So, well, we had an interview tonight, so it was 62 kids, so right now there are.
We're gonna list it.
Yeah. So Director Andy, Assistant Director Brittany, and then, we want to include in this list, but, so we have three right now over 18. So Izzy Salvati, Jordan Wall, and Luke Anderson, who is interviewed tonight, although not official yet, so maybe. And Janessa Pellman is a part-time.
She's 18.
And she's 18 as well, yeah.
So part-time as in, 14 hours?
She's the Monday, Friday girl, yeah, for 7 hours each one of those days. But she's also available, so we're gonna have.
Jordan and.
So some of these kids are taking up.
She's 18?
So like Jada.
Yeah, she actually.
Last week, and Janessa's gonna take her place, so as far as money goes.
Oh, it's Izzy.
It's sort of, yeah, she only got a little bit more, but.
Izzy's probably.
Yeah, and then, so under 18, we have three, Sam Mitchell, Jada Laughlin, and Brighton Early.
Brighton?
Yes, Brighton.
Brighton? Okay.
I think it was off the mission yesterday.
So can you review the under 18?
Sam Mitchell, Jada Laughlin, and Brighton. He's 17. So there are two 16s and one 17.
And the board was, you guys all got written in, the board was fine with a 49-to-1 ratio.
Seven is that? Especially with the full-time law.
So if we have seven, so if we have seven. Seven, not including Andy. Do we hit our mark? So that's 56 campers. So we kind of be responsible for people. Well, then we'll have Janessa.
I would still like to see at least three more.
Yeah, and then we should hire as many as possible. Because, you know, some of the counselors taking time off will fill the gaps to that week. It's always good to have a little bit extra hand on top of it. Something happens last second, you know, someone can't come in, we are still in the ratio.
What about the application that Roxanne turned in?
Does she still have it?
She turned in?
Yes, and I haven't had a chance to get to that yet. So that would be our next. He would be, he's 16, I think, so that would be the next interview.
Oh, yeah, like I didn't.
Yeah, I understand. Right, you sent it to me, I'm just, I mean, I haven't.
Did you send that to you guys?
Sorry.
You checked.
That's the problem.
So why is it?
I just got added too, so I. We're over.
Probably did.
I could have sworn that, like, I took a snapshot so you could call them for an appointment.
So, yes, but I couldn't.
Last thing's up though.
Interesting.
Here we go, June 7th. Oh, no, that's a transfer station.
Now, does that include any of our donations that?
Well.
That just, are you pretty much just running?
I'm running up a school, we take the registrations.
Let me go to my June 7th.
We can assume that the t-shirts between the.
Ah.
So that's 1250.
Right.
Actually, I don't have it.
Right, we need that.
Nope, there aren't.
The camper and.
Jared.
Also, the council.
No.
T-shirts.
And actually, it's as effective on some angles.
So we need to get them involved.
Oh, I talked about that.
Or is this to you?
We've got a couple of conversations going on.
Yeah, and I know what they were talking. So they're talking about the chance of a new hire. So what Jody, and now maybe we need to throw this back at the board here. So according to our numbers that we're running with the staff, did you just include Luke on that?
I did not include Luke.
So what do you have as us for income as of right now?
18,905.
So income, if we have income of 18,905, and I think I put this together with Luke and Brighton, my payroll, and that's without payroll tax, is like 21,800. So we are $3,000. If, well, that's because you didn't do Luke.
Can you write down how much, well,
so
how much he's going to
pay? I would be $8,000 flat.
And that, and how many hours, 40?
Yeah, 35. So he would be 22,40 for the summer.
Thanks.
So I don't have any, I don't have the payroll tax info. So you're the one, you're the lady with the payroll tax on top of that. So what is the, so if we hired Luke.
Yep.
We're at how much? Negative?
We already know we're in the negative. Okay. I didn't meet the number of students. But
right.
That doesn't matter. It's safety that's important first. We, the select board wants us to be revenue neutral, but without the number of kids,
right,
something's going to have to get somewhere else. The family pizza that goes home is now 20. I don't know. But
okay.
Yeah, it's the safety of the numbers. I don't want them to be short. I don't want them to have 12 kids under the age of 10 in anyone's care.
Yeah.
I would want that on me.
Okay.
So 4588 is the answer to that.
Okay.
Some of the things that we haven't really put in writing in about what things cost, would we consider, like,
we actually did.
We already did.
Yeah, a lot of that's already in the parent handbook that went out to all parents.
Okay.
Oh, there's Max and stuff already? Yeah. Yeah, that's all been published.
Oh, and the pricing of our pieces?
I was just thinking, like, going field trips from, like, 5 to 7, or something. You know what I mean?
They pay nothing for it. Are we already advertised that they don't pay for a bus or anything? Or?
The Tuesdays they pay for the bus.
Okay. Right.
Fridays they don't.
Fridays they don't.
It was already included in the day.
Okay.
We were expecting more. Well, that's how we ran our numbers.
So we get a bus with it.
True.
The deadline is tomorrow, right?
Right.
Bye.
Right. All right, so if we do, so we're still looking.
So if you interview the candidate that I emailed you, he's under 17 and a half. So that still gives your numbers a 51%, because your range is 3, 4, 5, 6 over 18 and 4 under the age of 18.
Mm-hmm.
So you're still in the, you can still hire a couple of younger kids.
Yeah. I have one that's interested. I'm just, he needs to be responsible and actually apply.
Sure.
The one that I know to.
Yeah.
I emailed him twice.
Yeah, I'm not going to hold his hand through the process. If he wants to join, he needs to apply for it.
So right now, we're good for ratio. Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Now, Janessa is available during that time, but that still leaves us one short because there's two, and we're only getting the one because of Janessa.
So are we looking for more like kind of like a substitute at this point? Like what Dan said, so we're at, you know.
I think we could,
Janessa,
we could do a substitute, because then with those subs, you could bring to field trips.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. know, that would definitely help in those situations too. And we are within ratio, but it's, with me, it would be nice to have at least one or two extra, so it can give us time to do what we need to do during the workday. Because if we're only within the ratio, we're including us, then that will conflict with what we're trying to do with paperwork, making sure the kids are staying on top of registration sheets for field trips and stuff, and et cetera. But we don't need like a lot more, but I think it would be nice to have a couple more, in a subject.
Just get one full-time, one's part-time.
Yeah, exactly. You know, especially like these weeks where some people are gone for a whole week, you know, those subs can come in for a whole month.
Would there be some kids in the town, like some 16-year-old kids who might be, I mean, just for like a week, like a kid maybe?
Well, and you know what, actually, that's interesting you brought that up. Like my niece, Luke's sister, is Kara Anderson, she's 16. She's great. So maybe if she wants to come in, maybe also I'll talk to her about maybe a part-time position. And if she doesn't, if she's not looking for that, you know, full-time sort of thing.
I said earlier, I have a 17-year-old that's interested. But like I said, I'm not holding his hand through the application process. He needs to step up to the plate and apply. But now we have that.
We're going to hold a breath on that one.
Yeah, exactly.
I work with you.
I actually just had a, and I could bring that up to you guys, I had an email about somebody, actually Dee, you might have to tell me if she sent in her registration. Does that look familiar? I think that's the mom. But she's looking for some extra time to pay for him, that she can give us like $100 by May and then have until the first day of camp to finish paying.
She has no before and after care, and her date for her payment was now.
Oh, I don't know
why.
Is there a possibility for of extension for the tuition for summer? We ended up having some extra finances. It needed immediate attention. It would be paid in full by the time camp starts. She really wants to attend, and I have a need for child care for summer months, trying to see what there are for options.
I don't know what we want.
You don't?
Be parent or...
Huh, so maybe she hasn't said. Looking to see if she emailed me in May asking about signing up.
Dave, thinking about finances, does your figures for staffing, you said we're in the hole, or does that include pre and post care? Because we didn't talk about like that pre and post care would cover the two staff coming in and then staggering the staff.
Going off that too, we're still, even though the deadline is tomorrow, but we're still taking campers. I just think it's smart to take the payment in full. So you want an extension on the payment? Because I feel like if they pay, you know, $100 ahead of time, then they're like, well, I paid. I just think it'd be harder to get that second half of the payment.
It's better to tell this woman, as long as you pay in full by the day camp starts.
Something along those lines.
Rather than, piecemealing gets a little.
Exactly, because.
And now what happens if a weightless kid paid in full?
They jump.
That's just that.
Do we have weight?
Do we have a weightlist?
No, it's going to start tomorrow.
But we could say, you know what, we needed the payment today, but we'll put you back down onto the waitlist. But if you can get your payment in by the first day of camp and you're number one on the waitlist, you're back in the camp.
Right. I just think since we have all the, we might have a little bit of wiggle room with the ratio, get a few more kids in, up to
the I just asked her if she had sent in any registration paperwork at all, because Dee doesn't have anything on this, and I asked her if she was So, if she gets back to you with that, I can tell her that there is financial assistance, so she needs it. Yes.
And she may qualify.
But only to Rollins for people, right?
Right.
Well.
She has to qualify.
Right, right.
And we have, you have to contact that other person.
I wasn't gonna contact anybody until we sent out a thing that assistance is available. So, do you want me to send that out?
Because there was one person that asked.
I'm sure.
Okay.
I'm afraid.
Okay, one second.
Well, I'm having to say here, that's why I was like, no, you can, no, I'll see what you're doing.
I should follow you.
So the consensus, let me just ask that about staffing, Luke, was Jody, were you good with that staff?
Yes.
Or should Luke?
Oh.
Yes, okay. All right, so I can do that.
No, we can't.
Oh, I can? He's gonna have to do it.
Dee? Oh, I'm not allowed. You'll have to offer Luke a job.
Oh, okay.
I'll just leave his information, so you should get to me.
Yeah.
Or is brother's going to camp or check?
Yeah.
Yeah, on the list.
Yeah. Since I'll just go, keep going with my business here, how about that?
Sure.
Did you receive anything more back about the extended school?
I have two. One is you.
Yeah.
And one is another one.
Okay, so I want to tell you, I received a email from Kate Lucas regarding the extended care or extended school day kids. And she asked, would there be a possibility of changing the Tuesday field trips to another day? Because she didn't want families to be you know, to have to make that choice, blah, blah, blah. So I told her I would come back to the committee. And Dee had already sent out that email to all the families asking, because that's after you guys had approved the sign-in for these kids.
Yep.
And so she sent out an email to all the families, and please let us know if your child is in extended school care. So the kind of funny and ironic thing about that is I was the only one who responded. To send email.
I don't know if you sent that out because I didn't get anything.
I don't think it's your email is it's I get personal email. Did you
check
that one?
I did.
Funny because I get responses back. You should go on that. It's not gonna check on
this
one.
Yes.
Yeah, it's how many days are we
doing?
Three. It's three.
It's generally
and
they say Wednesday.
No, it's Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. What do you think?
It's Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. What time?
It's only
in
the morning.
45 minutes. Oh.
I heard it's
so
only 45 minutes.
Well, so maybe they want to talk.
They stagger kids, don't they?
So the woman that answered me besides you,
yeah.
I think she was, and she hasn't responded to me yet, but I think she was confused with both of the people. I think she thought it meant post.
Extra care.
Yeah, because so she, but she hasn't gotten back.
Oh, so that was the only other person that responded?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Yeah.
So my question to Kate was, well, how many families are we talking about? Because we're not going to change our field trip day for me. Because I'm the only one. So one of my twins is in that. But the kind of funny thing I said about that was that he wasn't going yet. He's sending care on Tuesdays. 2 days of school a week is enough for my kid.
Unless,
you can go.
Unless you hear from more people, I don't think we should change the week.
Right.
Yeah.
That's
you
my view.
You do hear from more people. You shouldn't just. We got to move to Thursday.
Right.
It sounds like.
Right.
And this one's on Friday.
Right.
Did Roxanne already? No, when we go to those state parks, we don't have to like schedule a day or. We have to just basically pass for those.
No, you have to. We have to call them 2 weeks in advance to make that reservation. And we have, I believe Roxanne has done all 8 weeks, but we.
We're missing 1 week, July 18th.
Yeah, but otherwise.
Was she doing wait length with that one?
She wasn't sure, she sent me notes saying she was probably, yeah, if she's able to get in there.
She was talking to somebody about point four, I think it was up there.
I think we have two trips there, don't we? We have two.
And they might have changed it too.
That was beautiful, I was just.
Full bathrooms, a playground, a very sandy beach with a portable swimming area. Parking lot that's not boring.
And. My other, speaking of field trips, this might be a question for our directors, but also really for all of us. Pawtucket State Park called the town hall and asked about our, because that's our first field trip on the 27th. And they said they wanted to make sure that we knew they were in the process of hiring lifeguards, so there is a chance that they will not have lifeguards in place by then.
Switch that one out.
Well, that's what I was thinking, it's like, okay, is somebody else gonna be staffed for then, or should we just hold off and wait? I have a contact number that I can do that and just, I mean, maybe I can ask them what is their sort of plan for staffing or.
That's only day two of camp.
Right.
Switch a park out.
So we wouldn't really wanna show up at a place that didn't have lifeguards on duty. Yeah.
But I don't think it's like, I don't know if it's like swimming or anything, it's just trails and, I've never been here, but I've driven past, it's on the way to Concord.
Well, I just happened to have this. Did you see that, what I pulled out of my folder, did you?
Most impressive.
So here, I mean, I don't know if you guys want to look at this here. There are some kind of neat, you know, the thing is, we really don't know about, like, you guys look at that. You know, of course, we're trying to do things within an hour bus ride, just.
I have been to the Narrows before, it was for a fishing class with the school I went through. And it was quite a hike in from the parking lot, and it was paved probably half a mile or more into where the boat dock was to get to the lakes. And then I didn't see much of anything besides like a portal out along the way. So I didn't see like a play map. So, I mean, it would be good if we wanted to go on a nature hike or stuff like that. And I don't know, because we were there for a fishing trip, if swimming is allowed in the lake or not. What about if we can't do it?
What happens when we book these trips to us in advance and we get a room?
When we have our, I think, should we say subject to,
but do we get, do we lose that pass?
No.
From the, so we can just call them and,
yeah,
say we're not coming today, it's raining,
yeah.
You know, and you know, would they be, does the state say, check their calendar and say tomorrow?
Yeah, I think that's an option. I mean, I definitely think it's an option.
Like, I don't know how the bus schedule works and how that.
That would be more my issue, I think, would be the busing thing. Would they be available the following day is kind of the tougher,
right,
kind of question.
Yeah, they prefer a week's notice,
right,
for sure.
Right.
I don't know. So Brittany and Amy have Lisa's information.
Okay.
Posted. So I'm looking forward to taking it, but that would be a question if they want to contact her and ask.
Yeah.
Oh, I did.
We have eight trips scheduled, and one of them gets rained out. We have doing seven trips, so they don't go anymore.
Well, now we've got that week of the gym. The last week of school, gym is booked, so we can always look for another day, maybe.
If we wanted to not go on, I mean, I was concerned about that anyway, going on a field trip our second day of camp. Maybe we maybe we don't go on that field trip that week, we just go to the Jane Thompson pool, we book two for the last week.
And we'll also have to think about whenever that baby's gonna, so what, are they absolutely sure? That's what was discussed at the school board.
I thought it was before, I thought anytime before July 10th.
Well, they were going to do it earlier. They were gonna do it, I guess, in April or something?
Yeah.
And they got rang up. So then they got put back on the schedule. And the schedule says that they cannot get to them until like July 10th.
It does rain again. I think the thing about the field trip too is, in moving it, is the fact that we've already told the parents that they're gonna get, we can just take our field trip once a week, unless it's subject to weather conditions.
I think the parents would understand, I know I understand, I don't want my kid, like, in the middle of the field trip, when it's pouring rain.
Oh, no, 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 I meant we've already scheduled, we've already told everybody that, so it could be a beautiful day.
Yeah.
But we've already told everybody, you know, your kid's gonna be on field trip, it's subject to weather, but you are going on field trip this week, to State Park, so.
I don't know, do you think if we sent out an email that said the state park that we reserved doesn't have lifeguards, sorry, we're gonna have to postpone that till?
How much would it cost to go to Milton for that day? That's what I was thinking earlier, that I said, give myself.
It's like going to Milton three times.
That's not a New Hampshire State Park though, right?
No, but how much would it cost? I mean, you know.
No idea. Could talk to someone over there.
Milton, yeah.
My uncle is the police chief over there, and my aunt runs the town beach.
Or the other thing is, oh, no, like.
I don't think we get free, but I could.
No, but if it's.
I could speak with her.
Yeah, we already have the bus scheduled, it doesn't matter where the bus goes.
What was it?
And then we can just go to Milton.
That takes a college.
Oh, what about Main State Park?
Oh, it's not a very high state.
No.
It's a dollar a head to get in.
Baxter's Lake.
Where's that?
Rochester.
And there's.
It's the Rochester Farmington area.
I've heard of it, never been.
And then there's someone over in Southport.
Depends how many.
I think we stick to New Hampshire.
Kids show up, there's enough kids to go swimming, but I don't think if all 62 showed up, I don't think it's big enough for that. But there, it's free, there's like a loop around, the bus would go, drop us off, we set up a station. And it's a boat, where it's free, it's a boat dock where people can just drop their boats in, but people go swimming there all the time. It's like, it's the town beach for Rochester. Like I said, it's not big, it's free.
Do they have lifeguards for you?
No. That's true. They normally have a lifeguard, I can speak to them, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know, I think the tuck away situation personally, especially that first week, it's a little bit, strong.
Yeah, I would rather have it in pockets.
Yeah, it's just especially this, right, the start, you don't know, you know, you guys don't know if these kids, what they're capable of, and, you know, yet.
Yeah. I'd say we switch it with something else, where we know there's lifeguards, and then a little bit later, maybe they'll have lifeguards.
Let me call this week and just see where they are at staffing, I'll do that, so.
Yeah, I think Milton's like $3 a head, and 62 kids, it's $186, but I don't know if they can do a bus rate.
I'll speak with them.
Yeah.
I'm at New High School every day trying to recruit kids, so while I'm there, I'll ask her.
And I did do research on the Lake Star Parks, I got lost in the conversation, that they're a dollar a head to get into for kids 12 and under, or 12 and up. Adults, counselors should be $2 a head.
At the Main State.
At the Main State Parks. And there's one in Southport, right around the corner from the Hamilton House. And they have a little playground and a couple of more.
What woods?
Yes.
Yeah, right.
And then there's Fort McCleary in Decatur.
Oh, right, that's nice, fun, yeah.
And that's right on the water, there's no swimming.
Yeah.
But it's on the water.
There's also Fort Foster, where we hold this in this class.
Next week.
Yeah, so.
And do we figure out it was to rain and we can't go.
You gotta get a kind of date.
We should find rain dates. We can reschedule that, even if there's a loop, we do two field trips. If it, we find rain dates, I think that's the best we can do.
Is there alternatives to the, we need to fill it after we do another day or something like that?
Oh yeah, I have a day of cancellation, oh yeah, we could figure something out, that would be good, but. The field trips are part of their registration cost, it'd be nice if they got their field trips.
Agreed.
Speaking of movies, is there like a, where you probably know this, is there like a, what's the screen you guys have? School or to show a movie to a bunch of kids at the gym or?
I said it this weekend.
We were in a classroom, we were in a Kmart classroom, we used the smart boards.
Oh, okay.
Do we have a classroom?
We do, we have a classroom. Right.
Okay, so each classroom has a smart board. Yeah, I don't remember if the state has one.
You can even run into like a, you know, you have a movie in the morning.
Right. And,
I get my hands on a projector too.
Yeah, probably, yeah, the old fashioned screens of, you know, like same with the old.
Yeah, I don't know if I can get that, but maybe we could find like a flat.
I think we have a.
Area too, just a flat wall with nothing on it.
It was probably someone there.
Cause I can get my hands on a projector.
Yeah, I put a sheet up.
Yeah, we could do that too.
Yeah.
But.
I mean, if there's a stage too, you could just pull the curtains.
Yeah.
It's a.
I don't think it's waiting.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, not fun with it.
If you put something up, don't get a sheet, you know, like.
No.
Yeah, the gym will have a, is it light-ish? But they, we've had town meetings there and they bring the smart board on wheels.
Right. Yeah, there's one in the gym office.
Smart board?
So you could just use that.
Okay, yeah.
Cause they use it at town meetings.
That would work too.
So I think they would.
Yeah, if the smart board's too, I would need just a light board.
Yeah.
Buzz over projector.
Yeah.
Don't figure anything out.
The smart board bought a projector a little while ago that we never used.
That little mini one?
Yeah, that little mini one, if you can hook it up to.
Yeah, that's, as long as it has a.
And then we have a use for it, but they can't be too far away from a white board, that was the problem. But when you're talking to a bunch of kids, they're kind of, said one before anyway, but for this room, it was, you couldn't widen it enough to see clearly from the back of the room. Cause it's literally a little bit wide. So I'll bring that up and stuff for later tomorrow.
I just have one thing about movies, the sixth grade walk in, they can use that kind of permission slips for movies over PG-13. And they're gonna have some kids that are probably nearing that age who are allowed to watch them at home. And they're gonna wanna watch them, do you wanna do something similar?
We already did.
Oh, we did?
Yeah, so it's part of the registration packet. So I have all that recorded. There's, I don't think that there's any child that wasn't allowed to watch.
A PG, was it PG-13?
Yeah, so you guys will have that too, so.
Okay, cool.
But I can go sit there.
Awesome.
I should have a list of movies too. If they ask me, it's gonna hold us. Suppose the movies are gonna be watching on a rainy day.
Yeah.
I thought it was somebody else.
Me too.
Sure, everyone is gonna see it.
Give us a list of possibilities.
Just make sure that.
Okay, I know we're kinda all over the board, where were we last?
Let me, can I just, as I'm looking at my thing, okay, so the part about the extended school, unless we really hear from a whole bunch of other families right now, the field trips are staying Tuesday, Friday, correct? Is that everybody consensus? Okay. And what did you want me to tell the woman about paying in before the 26th or? That she will go on.
We didn't determine anything.
Okay.
I think we mentioned telling her she could ask for tuition assistance. But
if
she may not
answer.
Yeah, she may not qualify though.
Right.
Wonder if any of our parties say rather than taking a deposit, just say pay some full.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And if there is a wait list, she should get bumped back onto the list, so if someone signs up a little bit later and they have their full payment, that that's who we should take first.
Sure.
But if no one comes around and she just pays, she can come into the meeting. Because if someone has, if someone's payment ready, that's, you know, you should be paid.
I have what you posed as a question, and then my notes, I said concerns about waiting until people who have paid full get to jump before people who have partial payments.
Okay, so when I, so I can tell her that she can pay later, but she is not technically guaranteed as full.
Okay.
Yep.
So I think we said you weren't holding your spot if we get your $35 registration fee. Did we get anything?
That was the end, just snapped yourself.
Oh.
I asked, I don't know. You don't have anything from that name, and I looked through the emails that she had sent me, and there was no even mention of her child name, so I don't even know.
Okay.
So I have a question. So $35, we hold this spot.
Until tomorrow.
Until tomorrow?
Yeah.
Tomorrow, that's the day mark is due.
Okay.
Which I know people are coming into town on tomorrow to pay it.
Okay.
So, in response to your question, partial payments will be put on, partial payment campers will be put on the wait list, but there is no guarantee for a spot. Is that what I'm hearing? Okay, and how are we going to notify them so if they show up the first day with all of them? Robin has to for that.
You call them ahead of time.
So yeah.
We understand that.
D has all
you're
that.
You're paying
to
pay, but they're full.
Maybe the Friday before kids start
Thursday.
The deadline or Thursday.
No. Well, that kind of does bring up a good question, Celia, because I think I've heard from rumors in the past years that people have shown up the first day of camp and been like, here's my paperwork, and let me write your check.
Like a bag of coins.
Yeah. But maybe because how we've been doing things all along, that won't be the case. But is that, I mean, I guess we'd be like, okay.
And so we may get a situation where that's going to happen. So
right.
Maybe we should make a determination.
Be prepared
right
for that.
I just think if they haven't paid in full, then and there's someone, I mean, if there's no other waiting spots, then I guess, yeah, they should be able to pay by the first day of camp. But if there's people on the waiting list and they paid, I just don't like the idea of people paying right at that last second. It's.
Do you want to say next Wednesday? Or next Thursday, because Thursday, town hall is open.
We're already basically putting an extension on our registrations as it's.
So what's the date? Thursday,
June 22nd, which is the last
right.
day of school, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So.
Last day of school.
We have to know that.
Right.
And then.
We also would like to have a couple of kids.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Exactly. Right. So the wait list closes? Or are we notifying them?
So can we do like an official deadline extended sort of thing?
Yeah.
To do that?
Yeah.
And just say,
this is it.
Yeah, and that would be part of, it's probably going to end up Facebook it already. Now I can now I can like roll it into the deadline to be extended, June 22nd. Payment in full by June 22nd. Should I call out, there's no exception, we don't want anybody there June 26th, should I say that?
My question is this, if they can afford the payment on June 26th on Monday, should they afford the payment on June 23rd on a Friday?
Yeah.
Right? Who gets paid over a weekend?
I
But so
we do some different things.
So do we need to take a motion or a vote?
Yes, you guys are closing with the extended deadline ends June 22nd.
All payment and registration is due, right, in full.
Payment in full is due June 22nd at the town hall. Is that including for an aftercare?
Well, we're at max for pre, so
right.
Right.
want it on the 22nd.
So maybe,
I think we should get some sort of courtesy all the time that we put into this. So
I don't want any special treatment.
Just say you're like
for the record, I'm
not
no special treatment.
I say pre and post. Excuse me.
Yes.
Post-care. I need post cares.
Do 22nd. Last day.
Okay.
So Jody made the motion. And let me read it to make sure that it's correct. A deadline extension has been made by the Rec Committee to June 22nd when tuition is paid in full, including pre and post care. Is that what we understand?
Post.
Just post.
Just post, because we're
Are we all paid?
With the exception of that one.
I don't know. It's going to depend.
I know of four.
I don't know. I need to get a ledger from
okay.
Blaze. I didn't stop it yesterday. I did something.
Okay, so I can second that, right? I'll second that.
Jody,
no.
Come in.
This goes for this
I can second it. No one's
agreeing. All in favor?
Aye.
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 Any no's?
No. I'm not saying no.
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 See a bone? Are you a bone piece now?
I don't know.
We didn't make a motion to make that happen.
All right, so can we move on to another subject that I wanted to cover off, which was orientation and CPR, first aid being scheduled?
Yes.
Where are we on that?
I have something on that. The school, like the teachers, are doing CPR and first aid during the day on the 23rd. However, there are shifts, so only half of them are doing first aid and half of them are doing CPR. So we wouldn't be able to do both at the same time. But can we get in touch with Kate or
do we know how many need to be?
Everybody, I think. Right.
No, we have
one exception.
I think it's 50, but I.
Okay.
Do we have another big exception?
I have it in my other notes.
I think you gave them to me.
Oh, God. Yeah. Thank God. I was like, I have no idea what I do with those.
Whether or not I brought
it
is
the fire department doing their training?
I don't think I brought
it. I don't know that.
Because if they're bringing outside. You may not be able to
come
back on that.
Okay.
Because the fire department
yes.
Is
okay.
Doing it for free for us.
Okay.
I think
the
school
is yeah,
the school is their own island, the library
that's
is their own island.
Free.
And their
yeah.
Never mind
then.
So yeah, if they allow, oh, it's great.
Yeah, so only one.
But you're going to be set.
How are they going to be setting up?
Andy, you're certified, right?
Yes.
You're all set.
I'm all set for
but you're not, right? So Andy and Izzy, I believe, are.
Where are they doing CPR training?
At the school.
Because that's our setup day.
Friday?
Friday the 23rd?
Oh.
Well,
one of our setup days, right?
Look, I need to back up a minute. So, who's doing CPR training?
It's
the school
is doing it.
The teachers are doing it?
So
I thought you said that the fire station is.
No, I'm saying the fire station is offering it to us for free. She mentioned that the teachers happen to be doing CPR and that.
And
so
when,
or may not
and
done,
when can the fire department do it?
Yeah,
that's the problem. She has not gotten back to me yet. Okay.
So we have to pay for money.
She didn't come in
when
I
told
her. I have tried that out.
Yeah. It would have to happen Monday the 19th at this point. On their that's their training day. So
the
fire training usually happens on Monday nights, and they're usually down on Monday.
Can you zip him out an email and say, can we do this on the 19th for our camp counselors? We must know now.
Brittany, when can you contact the school and find out if we're able to piggyback on that so we have to
wait, let's, first up before we do that, I would like a point person with Kate. because we asked about paving, we asked about all these other things this week, and she kept saying, I talked to someone.
So Roxanne.
Now, I don't know who this someone is, and that information didn't get brought here either the way it was presented or known, or we were all unsure. So we need a point person to pave.
It was Roxanne.
But she has said a few things to me in passing, because I've been
in that school,
and right. That's why I've kind of been, so I don't know if that was comment was directed towards me or not,
so
I don't know. But
right.
It wasn't like, it was kind of one of those stupid comments.
So
like, well, wait a minute.
So that may be what she's talking about, because if she knows you're hired with us, and you're there as a
sub.
And then you're picking up your kids, and Roxanne's asking,
right.
That's where she got, that might have been where she got the, I talked to several people.
Right. I do, and so
Roxanne, I was all confused.
So Roxanne is the point person that it makes sense going forward for it to be probably maybe, because you have a connection with the
right.
School.
Okay,
so you want, so you'd want to talk to Kate and ask her about.
Yeah,
okay.
And then,
our point.
And getting our keys as well.
Kate
made the same comment to me
yes.
About the school board meeting.
See, comments.
That's what I mean.
Because
I asked about the shed, yes, clarification.
You no longer ask Kate anything, and she will.
about rec.
But
you
she said she would like to walk Andy and Brittany through the school to show them what's going to be accessible to them and how they're going to make accommodations for the paving. What sheds they're going to be, where the shed's going to be built, and what sheds are coming down, and so forth. And it's not going to affect the area of the garden.
Okay.
Is our shed coming down?
She said the two wooden sheds by the softball field
is what
so
I understand.
Yes.
All right.
So we used.
So we're losing our shed.
They're building another.
Should they offer to us?
I don't know.
Okay. Another question.
There you
go.
Four my understanding now. Was our shed was not going anywhere.
And that's what my understanding was.
Right,
that they
weren't replacing our shed. They weren't that we were in charge
of
our shed.
They then just move us to the one in front of the door. If they are getting rid of the other two, there's the one in front of the back door.
Oh,
that,
yeah, I do know.
I think
that
may not be able to wait more than a day or so because the leak was going to go.
Right, and
so we're not going to fix the shed that's being torn down.
I'm in tomorrow.
And is there anything in the sheds? There's stuff in the shed.
I put stuff in the shed.
So I'm asking her about the shed.
Details.
CPR.
Well, she wants to take you to a tour about
the
shed.
Brittany, so you've got the keys. That's the keys, first aid, walk through the school, and the shed. Okay, we're adding the shed to your list.
Yes.
Now, a Jody question for you. If she can't piggyback on the CPR, she contact.
I was just about to send up that email.
Okay.
So now that we're back to CPR.
Sorry.
No, it's fine. I mean, it's crucial that we find out as soon as possible, but I'm assuming the next time we meet is a week from today. Right?
No.
No. Okay.
Because that's Father's Day.
That is right. We need to have enough time to contact the counselors. Because if we contact them too late and say, oh hey, by the way, your CPR training's in 2 days.
So
we need enough time to at least let them know when they have to be down there. And that's the only thing I'm concerned about. I think we need to do it as early as possible. So if we could do it the 19th, I think that's great. But we need to figure that out as soon as possible so we can get that information out as soon as possible.
So you'll get the information out to the counselors, is that right?
I can do that,
yeah.
But I can't do that
okay.
Until
right,
now.
Right, I'm just making
yeah.
It clear, I'm just confirming that you'd be the one that would do that.
Yes.
And, yeah, you're absolutely right. Brittany, are you going to be at the school tomorrow?
I am. Yeah.
So you've
been
spoken for our meeting.
Yeah, and then see how much it costs and stuff. Because in Fire Department willing to do it for free.
Why?
But they don't have the time to do it. We may have to squeeze into the teacher's training. Because it sounds like you've been trying to contact the fire department, but they're not getting back in touch with you. So I think we need to use the school as a backup plan if we can get in there.
I have an answer. that in like 5 minutes, my mom's gonna get up for you.
Oh,
is there, what other day do you think Stafford would be able to do it?
The training?
Yeah, looking at the next couple of weeks.
I think we should be able to do any day as long as there's a proper amount of time. But like if, hey, the 20th or the 21st, your CPR training's that day. As long as we have enough time to let them know.
Yeah.
I think
that's plenty enough.
Yeah, I mean, we have a 5 day window that week.
So
that we could get it in there.
19th, 20th, or 21st.
Well, we need the 2 days of training, correct?
Yeah, what's that going to be?
General.
So, yeah, so general training. So, I mean, that would definitely be the 24th. But I could work around the CPR training as well. If the CPR is the only day they can do it, it's the 23rd, I can do a day of training on the 22nd. And then their second day of training is their CPR, and we can get back at it on Saturday. So, I mean, that second day of training, I'm pretty flexible with, too. As long as we can get them in there for the CPR.
If I remember correctly, it was maybe
when the fire chief came, he said Monday nights looks best for him, but Wednesday nights also.
I'm co-copying all of you.
Yeah, but he was saying, because they're explorers there, they have more firefighters there to run the place.
Yeah.
When can Rex staff do CPR and first aid? Is Monday the 19th available? We are down to the wire. If Monday does not work, what about?
Need to know.
I know that sounds dry, so.
Andy, are you saying that we can, the 24th, are you saying you can do the orientation training and set up the same day? Is that what we're thinking?
Sorry, I'm just pulling the calendar. So,
the 24th is
the
Saturday,
yeah.
Yeah.
So we need a day to set up as well?
Yeah, we need to get, so Saturday is the day we're supposedly getting into the school. You might want to find out what time we can actually get in there.
So oh, we're not getting in on Friday.
It's Saturday.
Oh, okay.
And I actually have a thought that Brittany here also she has a graduation party on this Saturday.
She wanted to do that for sure.
And I, from what I understand, right, were there other people that had graduation stuff going on? So,
yeah.
I don't know. Would Sunday be bad to do that? The day before?
The 24th is also the strawberry fest.
Yeah, so maybe we should.
Well, so if maybe we could get some people to. So Saturday, June 24th, is set up.
That's what we were thinking. Brittany would have to leave at what time, Brittany? Like noon. So, you know, what do you think about Sunday the 25th? Is that an option? Maybe that's.
How much time do we need to set up?
Brittany.
Well, it depends on what room we have, and where we decide. Yeah, you want to make sure you know where your tables are, so you can your registration table, whatever, your checking table.
No, I don't think so.
So, I was kind of thinking where Dan's at. If 24 is a bad day, we can't get people down here, but everyone else can make it on Sunday, and it's not going to be as long. I mean, that's really down to the wire, but if everyone else can do it on Sunday, then we should do the 25th as a setup day. And we can coordinate times for the trainings. we can leave setup as setup, so we can just get that done and over with. And we can make our 2 days. So if the 24th doesn't work, we can
it
set up.
Like it's a very busy day.
We can set up our 2 days within those 5 days, but we can be flexible based off of the CPR day.
Okay.
And we can just do what we were talking about,
yeah,
and just do 2 4-day meetings,
okay,
during that.
Okay.
What about, did you ever figure out where we're going to have the general training? Library.
That's kind of what I was under
the
impression we're going to add.
I emailed Sarah at the library. She said it was fine.
Except for which
except
day?
For
the Thursday, wasn't it?
Tuesday, like yoga and back.
Mm-hmm.
That's Thursday.
It's only one day, though?
I'm sure I have an email, I can check out.
Just to hop back to CPR and consider real quick, it's McGregor and outside, and it was company, so they can have the charges.
But it's the only, so back to.
The general one.
The general.
I'll find the.
That's only one day, that's just not good for him?
I gotta take a look at it, and again, I know, I think I sent her email.
Yeah.
Did you send it?
Yeah, you sent it to me too, and I'm just trying to figure out which one it was.
If, I mean, assume everything's perfect, I think the 22nd and the 23rd would be the two best days.
Yeah.
For us, but like I said.
Thursday, Friday.
Thursday, Friday for our training, but if we need to move something up because of the library or the CPR, I think we can do that.
She's pretty flexible, so yeah, I don't think it's gonna be.
Yeah.
Is it this one Thursday night there's yoga?
Okay, Thursday night there's yoga, that night, definitely Friday, Saturday if we are available.
He's not supposed to lie on Thursday night. Oh, so you can do it Thursday, but in alternate rooms?
Yeah, there's, yeah, they're just you and yoga in the back.
Oh, we just need a different room then, I'd say we just.
Basically, there's a really good size room in the back, and then there's a conference room in the middle that's not really huge, but.
Where we did the interviews.
Yeah.
I think, yeah, I mean, we're okay with this.
If she's totally okay with it, then why don't we plan the 22nd and the 23rd? Yeah.
So the 22nd and the 23rd?
Yeah.
We want to, once we find out about the CPR, if you want to.
The bottom.
Let me know, and I can email her.
Yes.
You know, exactly when we're gonna need it.
Yep. Yeah, I think the second I find out about the CPR, I'll email you.
Yeah.
Because then we can coordinate that.
Yeah.
But.
And then I can talk to her, and I should be available for.
Perfect.
But yeah, and you know,
and if somehow the CPR has to be at Thursday, we can do it
Wednesday,
Friday.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I think.
I think we'll be fine.
Personally, once you guys go on a walkthrough, you'll know with Kate, once you two go on a walkthrough, you'll know what you'll need for.
Yes.
So when is she available to walk us through?
Brittany will know tomorrow.
Okay.
Yeah, Brittany's your idea.
Alright. Worst case scenario, even because you work there, even if she walks you through and then you can walk me through it a different day, because if it's like during the school day,
right.
I can't get out.
Yeah, she
right.
Might even just be able to
do
it on the fly.
Yeah,
yeah,
she'll probably just do it with me in the morning.
Yeah, and then you can just walk me through it.
Yeah.
And do you have everybody's email?
I know, I think it's on their.
I have it compiled right here. I can send it to you.
Please, you don't mind. I think I have it on their sheets, like the sheets I was given, but it came from my family. I haven't gotten with me today.
So when do we want to do that?
Well, I think that's the first
Thursday.
Is that at the same time as the puppies are gonna be here?
Well, the community services, what, at
1:30. Right now.
For grades.
No, 1:30? I'm scheduled 1:30 to 4:00.
Okay, all right, so we can go after.
Yep.
After the,
And what is, what's, I can tell it was just like, yeah.
So I think that's gonna take a good 2 afternoons for that.
First and second week.
Yeah, and then the garden is always gonna be there.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't have any more commitments for volunteering. I'm still working on that schedule. The dance lady, what was her name, Megan, she was very, she gave me a back and she was so excited. And she said that she has 2 different programs that she could do, like once a week she could come in, or she does like a 1 day where she does, breaks the students up into groups and teaches them each a dance, and at the end of the day they perform. She said they do that at the, she's done that at the works. And I said, okay, that sounds great. What will this cost? Because we have our budget. And I haven't heard that for a
while. Oh, no.
Is this a volunteer? Dance time with Brittany. It's
so
gonna be a time slot.
You guys can get the schedule too. So you can manipulate it however you
want. Yeah, I have a copy of it. I don't know if you guys can make any changes.
Yeah, it's always changes.
Oh,
yeah,
I just updated it.
Okay, awesome. Do you want to tell them about the
paint for fun?
Oh, yeah,
no.
The one that Kelly gave us last time, the skateboard bike.
Yeah, I emailed.
Oh, you did? You checked that out?
Yeah. Did you get the email? No.
I didn't get any.
It's at $500. We can come for the day.
The whole day?
What's it for?
No. Remember that crazy bike dude?
Oh, of course.
I know I got the email. Maybe it just came to me, but it was like.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I don't know, but it was. It was like an hour setup and then a show for an hour or two, and then take down, and it gave the details of what he could perform on and stuff, but it did say $500.
Yeah, and he intertwines, like,
he has a speech of, or good positive stuff.
Yeah. Yeah.
To teach our children.
He sounded wonderful. It sounded wonderful.
But is he there for 8 hours? I mean,
Okay.
Can I read to you what I sent out, the woman that just responded to me, I said, have you sent in any registration paperwork and are you a Rollinson resident? I have not yet, and yes, we live on 3rd Street. So
if she can't, I'm afraid that even if she has the tuition system, she won't have all of that.
Yeah.
So
should I tell her?
We can.
Should I tell her that we just
extended
the deadline for payment to the 22nd?
Maybe 22nd.
So.
Yeah.
Should I ask her to bring in her paperwork with $35 registration fee?
Yes.
And put it on the wait list?
Yeah.
Yeah, because we need that information to get there.
So let me do, I will tell them.
So if that's the case, then you have to submit it, right?
Okay.
It's not cold.
That's okay.
Unless it's something stronger, I really don't want it.
And then you have to pay. Thank you so much.
Yes, you had the paper for fun information.
Yeah. Patty Spiali, this one that I'm working in is moving right next door, so I buzzed in. Her moving there, so I buzzed in to see her. And so she offered us $5 person, a child, if we get 25 or more to sign up, and they get to pick, she showed me, and they were really nice. They were the $10 ceramic items that they could pick, and she'll bring everything to the school, and it's $5 a person.
And then they get to take that home, right? They just paint it, and then they get to bring it home with them that night.
Yeah. And she said that she, you know, she asked what time did we start, I said 9, she said, so I'll be there at 9:15, 9:30, and then I'll take one to a meeting to 3:30, giving them like a 15-minute little break. And she worked, she was an art teacher at St. Mary's for years, and she's very calm, and she works with the kids well.
So can you put me on the cost again?
$5.
It's $5 a person?
Yeah, for everything.
That's great. So they would have, so she can do it in the morning?
Yeah, Monday or Thursday would be good for her.
Monday or Thursday, so.
Yeah.
But does it have to be in the morning? Just for the week. Okay. That was fine. I just wanted to word it a little bit. Because if we did, that's three of us in total. Mm-hmm.
For, say, our 60 kids, is that where you're doing your math over there?
So, you guys, what is your plan on how soon to let parents know if there's an activity coming up inside the class? What do you think? Those 2 weeks?
Well, I thought we decided that we're not charging parents anything, whatever we bring into the home.
If we didn't want to separate the kids, then
we can't afford it.
And we can't afford the $5, but we have to eat those costs. So, next year we'll have to charge.
So, what's something, but will we need to sign up just so she knows?
How many
people? I will charge more if we can pay for next year.
All right, so you guys would just need a sign-up sheet for that, though.
Yeah.
Just so she knows how much.
Right, and maybe less.
Depends how much of a notice she needs. I mean, if she only needs a week notice, we could do it 2 weeks in advance, do a week's worth of sign-ups, and then give it to her a week ahead of time. But what we got stuff set up on the front for in general. Say, these are the upcoming events you want to sign up for.
So do you want to continue communication with her, or do you want to hand that off to them to try to schedule her in? It's up to you.
Sure. Well, some of that money that we've gotten for donations can be used for that. And that's what, because we do have a few of those.
How much do we have in donations? Do we have the last sheet?
Well, that was the question too. So that would be bringing up a great question. If any excess money that we're making from t-shirts, this is a great idea to use that money for right now. I would be on board with that. How much are we thinking about t-shirts that were in the plus? Is our legal plus?
$200.
Oh, okay.
Well, from the C and J.
Yeah.
And we're, so we're like $400 between all of them?
Like our sales too, and yeah.
So we have about $400 that we could use for
something
this program.
What about other donations for people just paying the checks for?
I will go back here.
Yeah.
Talk to Tammy at Doulas.
Yeah.
Who we have a $600 grant from Malls for an education device.
Oh, right.
To do her program. If she were to do just two sessions, she needs to know ASAP because she has to put an order in, and it's going to be $10 per child per session. So it would be $20 for coming in twice, and one will be ceramics and one will be glass. So it takes a minimum of 2 weeks for her to get her stuff in, but she has to place the order 2 weeks prior, and so she can't wait until the first day of camp. Unless we're going to do the 4 weeks, because then she has clay already on hand. They can do 2 weeks of clay. Like they make a pot, and then she, at that point, the first week of camp, you would take who wants to do it, and she would come with like a pound of clay for each one of them. They make a pot for the first week. And then second week, they would paint that pot, and then that would give her time to get her order of what they're painting ceramics. Bring that the third week, and then the fourth week she would bring glass to do that. So
By using her door, we're staying within the grant money, so it's $600.
Not if we do the 4 week program.
If we do the 2 week program, we can use the $600 for that.
Yes, but let's just assume we have 60
kids who want to do it.
So that's $1,200 for two sessions.
So, which?
Like, yeah, so, I mean, we'll go as well.
I'm just saying.
No,
worst case scenario.
Right.
We do have, between the t-shirt sales, what we got from the police station already, or the Police Benevolent Society, and the Vicki Righteous Donation, we do have that money.
Right.
To do that.
So we have the $600. Plus we have $500 from that, so that would be $1,100 that we do have.
Yeah.
Right.
And then we have the $400 in t-shirts. So that gives us like $300.
So okay, $1,100 in grant and donation, and then $400 for t-shirts.
Okay. But
does the grant, is the way the grant is set up, it has to be used for new bikes?
Because she completed that, she filled out the forms. And the money, I believe, is going right from REF to her.
So maybe we do this. Maybe we just have dual bugs come in for one session. $10. That's our grant money.
Is there something she can do for one session?
She could do glass or a glass fusing project, or
maybe we should do that. If we can then have the money for Kathy to bring in the paint ceramic thing. So that would be similar to what Doodlebugs would do, but if we do the 1 day project with glass, and then we still have money to do the $5 thing with the paint.
I'll talk to Tammy about that.
I mean, it's unfortunate because we thought we were bringing in $1,000 grant money and it didn't happen. So I would love to do 2 weeks with her for our kids, but
I'd love to do the 4 week program.
I know, but that, you know.
So $1,500 we're going to take out the Udabugs, the glass project, and the painting fund. So we're hoping that with the $1,500 we can cover all three, right?
I can get you a breakdown of what I have already.
Yeah.
Wait, all three my DMs.
Sorry, it is Doodlebugs for one session.
Yeah.
Kathy. Last project.
Is it Kathy?
No, that is the last.
That is the last project.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay. Now, thinking through what Tammy does, and she usually doesn't, she likes the kids that are doing glass to be eight, because you can, the glass can fly out. So I'll have this up for see if she's going to do it with other kids too.
Well, they would have supervision otherwise too. I've done what they've done down there. It's not like you're holding these shards. It's
I'm just thinking my children in black.
No, it's not. No, I actually wouldn't even trust my boys to do that. So.
Oh, well, so.
And she does do a mural with like the Montparnasse school.
Yeah. No, it's really not. It's not like you're.
And I think. For her glass class where she goes out, that she brings like little beads and then glue them onto a piece and then use them down to a nice anywhere
checklist.
So we're thinking 60 kids of all of this would just be.
I mean, the thing is, if maybe we can tell her that if we could have her on retainer. If there's only 20 kids that sign up for it, then we could certainly bring her in again. But, you know, we honestly can't go forward with the cost. We just can't.
So we have $1,500 spent, and we have the doodle bugs with the glass project back to potential $600. And we've got the painter flowers to potential $300 if we have 60 kids, as you said. So that's $900 with 600.
But this is great stuff, but maybe get something different.
Right. And the other thing, too, is that with the money that we have, we also need to think about, well, what about some of the other activities that we're going to do? Like we're doing the tie dye.
Yep,
so
we need
money
for that.
We need get donations for.
All right, that's kind of like another arts and crafts activity, too. So we have to substitute that with an arts and crafts activity that's more expensive. Tie dye's not overly that expensive.
No,
right?
No, you can buy a kit and that goes for.
Yeah.
So good that kit is a regular t-shirt.
Right.
Yeah, that's actually on the first
schedule. Yeah,
that's
so you're really just buying the kit. So, I mean, if we're strapped for money, then we just use our tie dye t-shirt day as a replacement for an arts and crafts.
All right, so just so you know, we have tie dye on
$500.
Yep.
So, almost there, right?
Yeah, so if we're not going to do that. And we need to remind the parents of
the trick bike guy is $500. We have that $600. This might be a nice, it's something very different than hitting kids who are into arts and crafts.
I think it would be cool.
I agree.
So,
yes.
Yeah.
It's a purpose. It's not him just.
Is he faith based?
Yes,
that's good. Some people are funny about that.
No.
Not that I am.
You're absolutely right. I think it was more kind of like, wasn't it like kind of a bullying kind of?
I like those music guys.
Like,
yeah.
I thought I gave you guys that. Did I keep it?
I wrote down his stuff.
I might have it. I don't think I kept it. I think I handed it off to you two experts.
Programs, kind of extra programs that are different enough.
Yeah, I think that would be great. He sounds like
I'm
sure my twins would love it.
Yeah,
I agree. It's something different. Too.
Yes.
So speaking along those lines, go ahead.
So do you want to
Before we jump to that, wildlife encounters can come down into the whole group or up to 30 for $500. So that out of Rochester, the Center for Wildlife can come in for it's
160.
Yes. I contacted them, and they're scheduling out right now to September. But I told them, I gave them a Thursday, the first week of August. And they said they have an event appointment that morning, but they could come to us in the afternoon. And it would be $175 for them to come in and
the
do
raptors.
It. I think I did seasonal animals and how they adapt. So they could come in and
I think they have a limit of number of kids they could do too, but it's $150 for the presentation plus mileage from their center here, which ended up being $15 to $20. And then Seacoast Science Center out of Rye does the same thing of $150 plus mileage to do aquatic features. And all of that is on the drive. So
does the aquatic center do up to a certain amount of kids as well?
I think it's 30 kids at once.
I think it's better to spend the money on something that could be done in the high school. Not limited to kids, especially with, you know,
I hate to watch on both of those, but you don't have to make this year.
Yeah.
You are over budget already. Mm-hmm. And then you spend it on $150 plus travel for a one-day event. We still have to buy art supplies,
mm-hmm.
paint,
right,
chalk,
right.
Easy ups,
sport,
big
stuff.
Water thingies. Remember that big water jug? We still have to buy that stuff.
Yeah.
All that has to come out of that budget.
But then you stick to the three you're talking about. This year.
Let's begin.
Yeah, it's
fabulous.
So what
these
are
all great things that maybe
right.
end up doing next
year. So what are the three things?
So the three are the Doodlebugs, Paint for Fun, and I think we just added more to the video.
But that's $1,400.
What was the motorcycle?
bring a motorcycle game in.
Operational talk.
So, but that's, you know, that's $1,400. And not to mention, speaking of supplies, have we got any water donations and stuff? That's all stuff that's going to have to come out.
But we're making money off of that. I mean, we're not giving water away, we're selling it. So,
right.
Essentially, we're going
to
dish out money, but we'll get that back.
Right.
Hopefully.
Personally,
hopefully.
I would say let's wait on, I think, let's wait on him because he's the most costly. That we don't have money for in our budget. Like the Doodlebugs is costly, but they have
a grant.
Yeah.
So, you know,
so and we could use that to buy our waters and our stuff like that, and other activities that maybe the counselors come up with that would be fun to do. So we could maybe put home on that.
Mike, how much of
a notice that we need?
If we get a grant to come in from like Waste Bank or something, which I have to finish tomorrow, such as Dan is collectible, then maybe that's $500 that could go right to him.
That would be great.
The swimming is
huge.
The parks, that's great too.
Yeah.
We look at these two programs. And,
Let's ask. I just need a few more questions. Who's going to get him or you to the pay cash, Jerry? Do you know? How's that going to work?
I have the lockbox at my house.
Tell me how to give it to me.
Okay, so they'll get that. And what else? As far as things we need to start us off with the waters and the snacks. Now, if we need to get money for that, you two will take the responsibility and getting maybe stuff that we need for snacks. Because I can still donate items and bring them in anyways, but is that going to be their responsibility?
At this point, after starting moving forward, it will be, but you have to come up with a number to put in your chat box. Because that has to come out.
I think Dan Caroline said it was 50 or 55.
That was 50. That we talked about was 50.
I think she said 50.
Is that for the week or just, is that right?
Just
kind of
start.
And you guys need to keep track of the penny box, so I guess that'd be important.
And I'll put a let's do a purchase order now just in case something happens for supplies. Okay.
I'll figure it out tomorrow.
So, going backtrack a little bit to answer this question about supply, I stopped by Staples last week, and they said usually during the school year, when things go on clearance and don't sell, they donate them to schools. And the assistant manager took our information and said if they get stuff on clearance over the summer, that they would be happy to run it by their general manager and possibly donate to us. So art supplies and stuff might come in for Staples throughout the summer. It's got to go through the general manager there. Also, speaking about donations, I would suggest maybe the first week we go over to Weeksy's Pizza in Dover, which is right next to the train station, because we have $50 in gift cards.
Oh, nice.
How many did we get? We got two, so two 25 gift cards for a total of $50. And you just go ahead and order them, and that will help cover your pizza the first week. Caroline does not want to know anything about the gift cards. I put it in my tupper. She says,
gift cards, that's not an option.
She said gift cards are just a headache budgetary-wise. We count it as a pizza donation, as like a goods donation.
I will clear that up. But yes, you can't just close your eyes. Yes, that's not an option.
So she said to go ahead. I asked her on Thursday to give them to Andy, and he keeps track of all the gift cards that come in, and he goes and uses them to buy what he needs. So I did mark it and got them in there. I also went to La Festa and Kendall Pond Pizza, which is right next to Tomatoes, and left flyers with them, and I have more flyers to go out to basically every pizza place in the Somersworth Dover area, asking if they could donate either pizzas or give us a promotional deal or something, and they were going to be forward up to the chief of command, up to assistant managers and so forth. So we might be getting pizzas out of the Duke's Street. And then before the meeting started, I mentioned that I had gone back to Tomatoes because I was right there going to Kendall Pond, and I brought in the paperwork and I was waiting in line. It was taking forever, so I went to the back and asked to speak to the manager in the back, who actually is the general manager of the store, or the owner, and he is going to have a donation for us from the mayor of the store, which is one of the things. Yes, that's why I did that. I've seen them at a couple of meetings.
Yeah.
So, I don't know what we're getting from Janino's, but that'll be coming in this week.
Yes.
Maybe some steak dip.
I'll keep those at my house.
So, I told him either money or snacks, water, anything that gave him the whole list. It'd be
nice
that he get on top of that. And then he said, knows people, of course, you know,
that's the lifestyle.
So they are going to be giving us a donation, which will drop off here, probably. And then I did have a question. Yeah, I discussed it.
I can ask one if you want.
Okay.
I just want to ask her. Do you know we have the supplies at this point?
I haven't.
I'm assuming that we probably cannot use any of the school's like art supplies.
I'm assuming that.
That's all going to get locked up because she's moving.
Okay,
so none of that's going to
be. We need a bunch of stuff. We need it like before.
Yeah.
Yeah. Gosh, I can send it also.
Is there too much?
Okay.
So now I
have. So would we be a PO for that? So how does that
work?
For me, it would be a donation. For me, it would be a donation, but whatever they donate it in.
Right.
But a great way is to give us the list. And, hey, if your kid's coming, you can put it in your newsletter.
Yeah.
And we're going to need these for the first day.
We're in the school business.
You're going to get boxes and boxes in the tree box.
Yeah.
So
I'll
do that for the next
coffee.
Do you want the regular blue?
So why wouldn't gift cards from Weezy be counted as just a donation?
I feel like kids are just going to email them or something.
Yeah.
They are a donation.
I was one of those.
It's quite the way.
Yeah.
It's the way Caroline puts it.
It's an accounting thing. It's income. It's still income.
That is right there.
So.
That's such a pain.
So I have one of my.
Walk on the go.
I hate that. So my question was, how are we going to, like, publicly, like, I know I've got cards from Kristen that are going out to everybody who's donated money already, and I need people to send me contact information, like whoever's got you the magnet set or hold
yeah.
set.
Yeah, awesome.
Can you send me contact from the fire department and whoever donated all the other games,
mm-hmm.
and I can get thank you cards out to them too? But how are we publicly recognizing them, like on camp, during camp? Do we want to ask Kristen to make a poster that can be on display somewhere at the school? Do we want to do it on Facebook? Or these are our partners. Please, like, these businesses are supporting our camp. Please support them in turn.
Yeah, either way, it's fine. I can do it on Facebook, but you have to send me this.
Okay. And then.
And what about the donations? So what about, like, do we have some sort of tax thing that we are giving? Like, so this woman who owns her company who donated the badminton and volleyball, do we have any type of form that she could do for her tax purposes?
I think it's more monetary, isn't it? It's a monetary donation.
That is a very good question. No monetary donations. We have the ID number that they
right.
use. As far as items go, that is a very good question.
The last select board
yes. Yes, that's their name
yes.
to that.
Yes, there's a letter for it.
So we'll have to get those. Because she will have the receipt for purchase, but not like the fact that she gave it to us, right?
Right?
Yeah, it needs to be some sort of dual confirmation if you're going to use it for your corporation right off.
Right, like in softball we have a form letter. We donated blah, 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 here's our tax ID, and so you get into your account.
Yeah. Okay.
I have a question about sports inventory, which of course I'm the chairperson.
Are you asking yourself this question?
No. That's... So, like, you know, we want sporting events. We need sporting events. So, how would you use a way of doing that, getting our hands on it? If we were to do a purchase order, could I go to Target, buy some stuff, and be reimbursed? Or, like, so, what's the best way of, you know?
Getting out of here. I mean, what do we need?
Do
we have basketballs?
We have a ton of basketballs.
Okay. Oh, from yeah, that's
remember?
Right. Where the
it's upstairs.
Yeah.
No, but I was even thinking about
oh,
the
yeah.
love for
oh,
donation.
That's right. That's right. Okay. Yeah. I mean, well, that's true. Really
so what do we
yeah.
have? Like, I don't know, frisbees or
right.
we now have a volleyball.
Yeah. Right.
A ball came with it. I have that at my house too.
There
yeah,
is a sports inventory on the
right.
Right.
I said that.
Oh. Okay. Right. So what we have. Is
could include that in our list of what we would need, right?
Yeah.
So we need anything, so we need volleyballs.
Let's see where I go.
There was one
volleyball
with that.
Okay, yeah, we had 10 basketballs.
Yeah.
3 footballs, I totally forgot about that.
I have a black volleyball.
Balls off of that, so, yeah.
Any like soccer, we need soccer balls, kickball.
No, I have soccer balls, or kickball.
Ooh, about 4 square balls.
Yeah.
That's
kind of
like the kickballs. Do we have those? I don't think
we have
them.
Any of like the soft, meshy dodgeballs?
Yeah,
I
just thought kickballs.
You know, like, if you guys, they play softball during summer, right? Up at the field, have you guys seen that before?
Yeah.
Just have kids bring their gloves and everything.
Oh, I got that.
Honestly, you
have
gloves. There's a ton of gloves.
Oh, I think I have a couple of things
too.
So,
do we need frisbees? Do we need frisbees?
But we need to bring them all to the school.
Frisbees would be
I guess the real problem is we need somewhere to store all this gear. at this point, we're gonna find out what they're soon.
Find out tomorrow.
The shed.
About the shed, the state of the shed.
Jumper? Or do they just find out?
So I guess that is my question.
And Kate, you'll see, when I talked to her last Thursday, said in the past they've had sprinklers or water boys.
I was just gonna ask you that.
On really hot days, and you will, she's not sure if she has a hose that the school will allow you to use, but there is access to water, so you might wanna put a hose and a sprinkler on your list.
I was gonna ask you that, it's funny.
There's a hose in the shed.
So there is a hose, but it, like, sprinkler.
It looks like it's a sprinkler.
Are we allowed to use it though?
So it's our shed, that's our shed.
But can we use, do they have access to the water or anything like that?
I don't think so, I don't know, I didn't hear of anything like that, so I don't know.
They just pulled the drought situation.
Yeah, the drought's over, you're all set.
Drought's over, or at least it's, they pulled that, I think they're pulling it, they pulled that, so. Water your lawn now.
Yeah, you can water your lawn now.
So while we're talking about this stuff though, cause we're gonna plan to get together so we can talk about this stuff, is there anything that we probably should need so we can put this on our list to talk about, and we can put a list, like a final list?
Supplies.
And it says, yeah, this is what we're gonna need for supplies.
Now, you mentioned that you have a lot of cones and flags.
I have tons of cones, ladders, flags.
So that kind of, so the football, and we have 3 footballs.
Yeah.
Football is seems to be covered.
Yep.
Softball,
I have tons of flags.
We have 5 softball bats. Kids can bring their gloves. We don't have softball bats. Oh, that's right.
Do we use softball or do we use tennis balls? Is that safer or?
Well, I have the squishy balls.
Okay.
They're 10 inch and they're squishy.
They got a little right.
Okay.
And I give to it.
And I have all this. I don't know if you guys have access to that, but I will email my. I will email the full committee and give you guys what's already in inventory and what's on our donations list, so you guys can review.
All right.
Some of the stuff that we.
Are we donating all those 3 things to the fire department, right?
Are you emailing that to us?
Yeah. But this one is from the.
Oh, that, yeah.
But I will email it to you because some people don't have access to the front.
Yeah.
I'm working on a bocce ball thing, so I get, working on work for bocce.
We have an extra bocce ball set too.
Bocce.
Bocce balls.
So I guess we'll probably all set to start.
I mean, there's a lot that you said that we could look at, like our softball, kickball. I mean, if we have to use the kickball, softball.
And jam. Somebody told me about that tonight. Cornhole. I got a.
But yeah, soccer ball, kickball.
Yeah, I mean, we can kick it on softball. You sure you can kick it on baseball field?
Yeah, that's probably because we don't have anything. We don't have those. So.
But
it's something that go off in frisbee stuff. So
ultimate frisbee.
I went on to Dick's.
Kids love the whole one goal, other goal. I used to do handball.
Using the whole field.
Use the whole field,
yeah.
Some kids are working with handball.
Yeah, I don't know if you see it's good. It's a good field.
Do you have any nets?
It's not. We have
the
post.
Because I was going to order that, and I was like, eh.
So one couch is going to have to stand by one goal.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
That
and
tree
you have
and
too.
And
that
light
window.
Post.
You have croquet too.
Oh, nice.
Launder.
You're
going to see
me
on
that.
Launder.
What's up,
so I have one question that I want to run by you guys. Currently, I have 5, 6 people on the list who ordered t-shirts with not paid. No, 3.7. That is, the shirts are due in the next week or 2.
Double-bagged shirts?
No, we sold rain gloves to the community.
Do you know who those people are?
I
or
do.
Can you write them down for?
I.
Is it somebody that we know that we can harass?
You can contact them.
Because I'll do that.
Do you want me to
yes,
contact
yeah.
them and harass them and say if they don't pay?
If you don't want to, I will.
And, so, because we've ordered their shirts and haven't paid for them.
Yes.
And if they don't pay, I think they should go back into the pot to be resold.
Yeah, I think you should get in touch with them and tell them they need to turn that in over the next 2 days. or sell their shirt to somebody else. It's very simple.
Okay. It's Sean.
He's
I just got an email back.
Okay.
And he co-copied all of it. So I wrote what I wrote to him, the chief, and the lieutenant, the assistant chief. And he says, I'll be in California for that week of work. I'm pretty booked after the 4th between work and other commitments. I will stop by the select board meeting tomorrow night and discuss more. If you are under a time crunch, you might need to hire a company to do it. I will make a couple of recommendations. Now he's going to tell us on June
11th.
But didn't you expect that we were going to ask him for a bit of time?
But I gave them dates weeks ago, and they said, I gave them all the Saturdays, and the Saturdays didn't work, and I asked what days work better, and they got a response back. So, is he the only one in our department that offers CPR?
Yeah, Rob said that too.
I might have a contact.
I may have one too.
My buddy, who is the pool director at Jenny Thompson Pool.
Forward this
up.
My aunt, who's she's the one that trained me for my CPR. She's a gym teacher at New High School. Same aunt that works at the Beach Town Beach. But I can talk to her. But
can you look up the name with the star next to it? See if they are on your registration
school
list.
Oh
yeah. Okay.
Is that a pretty standard? Is that like a company thing, or is that
so?
Like,
the email is not.
I'll re-email Sean and say, "Do you want to
show
me?"
Yeah.
Who it is?
The
top one.
She
she had made a comment about
how much are we willing to pay
sending her kids only a couple.
Yeah, let's say that's too expensive. How much are we willing to pay?
And said, it's
what's
in
the
budget?
What's in the budget?
I want two shirts, and I wrote back to her. Are these camper shirts, or? Because she just said about for two kids, signing them up for 2 or 3 days a week.
I don't know. I don't recognize my email, but maybe I'd have to go check.
So I have no idea whether she want, and she never gave sizes, so I didn't know if she wanted camper shirts or adult shirts. So I never heard that.
I don't know. I have to go check.
Is she the only one?
Everybody else gave sizes. So I know that they all wanted the gray. Everybody else got back to me and said, I wanted a gray, the gray shirts that are advertised in the emails.
All right, I'll find out.
But is that the, I thought you said there was three t-shirts, or just two shirts that weren't paid for?
Oh, there are seven people that have not paid yet. That's six, and then I have one over here.
Guilty. Wait, the top six right there?
The ones in yellow. Oh.
Okay, can we plan our next meeting?
Yes.
Tomorrow.
I think.
Do we already have one scheduled?
By Tuesday at the latest. Because we have prepaid.
I'm fine for the next week and going Father's Day. So I'll be sleeping this second, so it's okay. I will not be here.
I don't know. Don't tell Scott I didn't know.
You're
done. You're checked out.
No, I'm not really.
Probably I'm doing the setup on the 25th, too. Well, it depends on the day. If we could figure out the CPR day and we have our 2 days of training.
Yes.
If you plan on a day that we're doing that, we may not be able to make it,
But that's okay.
Yeah,
we'll work around
That's okay.
It's better to have it in the book and move it.
All right.
Not have it in the book. So. What about the 20th, Tuesday? Jody?
Yeah. That's
your
I think we're just emailing third
Budget doesn't meet on Tuesdays.
Their meeting is coming Tuesday, and they meet next month.
Budget doesn't meet till next month. What can we do, I'm forgetting.
Who else meets here?
Yeah, Tuesday, that work for you?
Tuesday the 20th?
Kathy's on Tuesday.
No, zoning availability comes up when there is an issue.
Conservation commission.
At first I was like, hello, Kathy.
We'll get there, no business.
Yeah, what time are we saying? Our sevens? Is that good?
Yeah, that's fine.
Who wants to send out the note to D's adults?
Because I already have the, to get that thing out.
Okay.
As I sent you my financial aid, what I was gonna put out there, so I sent it in email, so look it over.
Is that what you were looking for, to us just to go over that?
Yeah, short and sweet, and it's, it gives the guidelines.
So, well, you want to read it out, we'll go, just, I mean, do you, can you, or?
Yeah.
Speaking of, do you, when are you leaving? Because I've been working with Kristen to get email blasts out, I told her next week we will get an email blast about the way that's going to change the guidelines. I will be on this week. I will be on this Tuesday morning. And Tia to get, well, not Kristen, but Tia.
Okay.
To make sure we get something out, so the deadline. And so there will be no wait list too?
I mean, it's very self-explanatory, me doing it.
Thank you, I didn't understand what it is. It's got your eye.
Nothing.
Final call, what can we do in 20 seconds?
Yeah.
Final call?
Yeah, okay. Absolutely.
Yeah, we can call a final call.
Yeah.
Final call?
Okay.
All in favor?
Aye.
Close enough. Yeah, Camp Raleigh has scholarships available. Camp is about to start, and if you need financial assistance, please email select board member Nate. My email and my phone number, guidelines are listed below, and it just gives the graph.
It's perfect.
All right, that sounds great.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, well, who's my show?
No.
Well, as you said, that's fine, but we don't have to ask for it.
No, sometimes they do it for free.
Oh. So we made, was that just a motion on the financial aid?
I just wanted you guys to look it over before I sent it out.
Okay,
sure, it's a motion.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Oh, yes, I'll put it on in parallel and stuff. Motion to adjourn.
Second.
At 9:00.
All in favor?
Aye.
No noes?
Definitely.